see osweni uyakhonza la ukwazulu singabashaya masenze kanjalo niyobona zulu umnyama angeke sibene kube besinikeze inkinga lapha baba ngoba ukubalulekile ukuba sikhumbule ukuthi nabo bangabantu.
Good morning, family. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, please go ahead, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so that YouTube will let you know every time I upload new video. If you are returning, welcome, welcome, welcome. It's always great to have you here. So today we're going to be talking about the Zulu King and the foreigners in South Africa. So the Zulu King did address the people of South Africa that are saying that the foreigners must go. And he said, "You're supposed to be very happy that people from other countries are coming to South Africa because that means that there is something special about your country. So for you to leave your own country to go to South Africa, that means that there's something special about South Africa. But you must be able to give them the directions, to let them know that there is law in South Africa. This is how we do things in South Africa." This is what I have been saying before, that for someone to leave their own country and come to your country and sell the stuff that they are not supposed to be selling to young children, that means you were already doing that in your country, because there is no way someone would leave their own country and then they don't do that thing. And then they go to your own country and then they'll start to do things that they were not doing before. That means they go there and meet the main boss that are doing the things, and they join them, put head to head, and be able to do those things that they are not supposed to do. So I know most of you came for me in the comment section, but that is just the truth. That is why the Zulu King made that statement, that you supposed to be the good example in your country. When a foreigner come from Nigeria, come from Ghana, come from Cameroon, and they arrive in your country, you're supposed to be able to give them a direction that this is how we do in this country. Here we have rules. Here we have a king. And this is how we do it. Not for you to take the laws in your hand and start beating the foreigner. If you are going to beat the foreigner, that is not going to work. Things are not going to be okay. But if you give the foreigner the directions that in my country, this is how we do things, everybody will be happy. But you taking laws in your hand, nothing will ever work. So if we walk hand in hand and we walk together, and we will be able to all be happy. So I'm kind of like happy with his statement, because I feel like this is exactly what is happening in South Africa. So they just take the laws in their hand, and this is what has been happening at the moment, where they go on the street shutting down shops, beating up people. This will not make anything okay, and instead it will make South Africa to look like it's a country that is not safe, it's a country that is not good for business, it's a country that is not okay for tourists, it's a country that is not okay for any family to visit, it's a country that is just not okay. So I do think that those are things that you have to put them into consideration when you are approaching a foreign in your country. You as the citizen in your country, you're supposed to be a good example in your country, to be able to give the foreigners direction, to be able to welcome foreigners in your country. But it seems like it's the way around. I almost forgot the most important part. He also mentioned that when people come from other countries to South Africa, you are the one that's supposed to tell them that here we have a leader and we have to follow the rules from the leader. But if you are gonna take the people and keep them with you in Johannesburg and let them eat those things that you are eating, then that is never gonna work. I am then now scratching my head. Are you? Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I will see you again on my next video. Bye for now.
asuma sikuphatha kabi nomhlukumeza abantu bangaphaya bangaphandle siyazi ukuthi indawo abasuke besuka kuzo bezofuna noma bezobheka impilo engcono ezweni lethu tunafanele ngabe siyajabula yinina sizwe ekumele ukuthi nibakhombe indlela ukuthi uma ukuthi ungasenigeria ungasekhamelun noma ungasegana manje ithi kukwazulu sinenkosi-ke thina la manifuna ukuhlala la hambani ukhonze enkosini siyokwazi-ke ukuphilisana nalaba bantu kodwa uma nizohlala nabo emadolobheni ngendlela ezinto eniyidlayo angeke kulungele ukuthola nabezini lapho nje asingakhohlisana batsheneni ukuthi sinenkosi-ke thina la siphila kanje asambe mfowethu siye enkosini kuyakhonza la ukwazulu singabashaya uma senze kanjalo niyobona zulu umnyama angeke besinikeze inkinga lapha bantu ngoba ukubalulekile ukuba sikhumbule ukuthi nabo bangabantu abazonelwa lokhu engihleze ngusho ukuthi isilo esekuzile sasisho ukuthi umuntu akaboshwe ukuthi useyisilwane aphathwe njengesilwane.
So there you have it, family. That is the video for today. If you like the video, please give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And I will see you again on my next one. Have a blessed day. Bye.